Photos from the set of The Batman have everybody fired up online, but one thing in particular is starting a very interesting conversation. BD here, and if you're anything like me, you're looking at every piece of content about upcoming movies you can get your eyes on, including set photos sniped from way too far away to tell if the Batsuit actually looks good in The Batman, but that's what we have, so that's what we're talking about. Some of these pics really riled up fans about a key Batman detail, but before we get to that, let's acknowledge this is straight up the Long Halloween comic brought to life. First of all, Selina Kyle is straight up rocking funeral attire that looks just like it did in the Long Halloween comic. Now, I know what you're thinking. Isn't all funeral attire just kind of the same, like dark and sad? Well, yeah, you have me there. But furthering this are the scratches on Salvatore Moroni's face. This little crime boss has no idea he has Catwoman on his arm, and you want to know how he got those scars? Watch the movie. Let's also take in the fact that they are at another funeral in the Long Halloween comic. It's essentially murder after murder. It's a murder mystery where someone keeps picking off people with every new holiday. So all that death means funeral home business is going to be booming. In the trailer from the movie that we got at DC Fandom, it looks like the Gotham bigwigs were already at one funeral, but that one literally got bombed. This one probably isn't the same because they don't seem to be leaving in as big of a hurry as they would be if it got bombed. But here's what has everybody all caught up. The stuntman suit for Batman, which for some reason just has a complete inability to look really good in pictures, has a gun holster below its hip. Mess with the bat, you get the gat, eh? All the Batman doesn't kill people are like, please say psych right now. Okay, psych. Any good Batman fan knows this is probably just a grappling gun. It's like his signature tech.
Gas-powered magnetic grapple gun.
Plus, we literally saw Batman using a grappling gun in the trailer to get up a staircase and out of a building. Where did he get that grappling gun? Well, the holster seen in the photos, which has everyone on social media freaking out, screaming Batman doesn't kill, of course! Matt Reeves and Robert Pattinson's The Batman probably won't be carrying guns, besides the one that killed his parents and has been split in half and used as his suit's bat symbol. That's metal. Matt Reeves seems to be hitting an absolute home run with the Batman from everything we've seen, and he is straight up adapting the Long Halloween comic story into a movie, probably with some shades of other books here and there, planting seeds for the next two movies in this trilogy, which is still happening, despite some awful stupid internet rumor earlier this week claiming they were canceled. I needed a good laugh. Anyway, would you be okay with Robert Pattinson's Batman killing, or do you think he needs to just keep being vengeance, beating criminals to the point where they're just shy of being Glenn when he met Negan, and then going about his day to the next criminal? Share your thoughts in the comments section or send them my way on Instagram at BrandonDavisBD and head over to comicbook.com/DC for more updates. I'm BD, I'll see you there.